Hi, my name is Heather. I am a health promotion practitioner from Access Health and Community. Thank you for joining myself and Akand, who is here to share their experiences of the COVID-19 lockdown. We will talk about some of the challenges, what positives may have come out of their community, and how to stay safe. Welcome, Akand. Please tell us a bit about yourself.
Hey there, thank you for having me. I'm Akand, I'm 19, I'm an international student from India. I sound a bit odd because I used to live in America for a bit, so I picked up a teeny bit of the accent and a teeny bit of their love for sugar, but that's okay. I'm studying a biomedical science degree here, doing my undergrad. I've been here since 2016, and at the moment I live in Mount Waverly in the city of Monash with my family, my mother and my two elder brothers.
How have the restrictions changed the way you've been living your life and, you know, with the community that you've been interacting with?
I think this year, in a word, has been a roller coaster for everybody. But I think certainly as an international student and a uni student even, I think it's been like a bit of an odd journey, especially seeing that my sort of network and community are so varied and so wide, like across Melbourne, because of my friends from uni, the sort of the people I engage with through my mental health sort of advocacy journey, and the people that I meet here, and even my sort of childhood friends that I've known who are back in India still, and my friends from America, I've kind of felt like the distance really got to me during this time of us being apart. And, you know, with going online with our education as well, there was an added stress of, you know, keeping up with my studies and performing well and not letting my parents down, but still having to bear that sort of tension and stress and uncertainty of this year, really. So it's been challenging, but, you know, I think the sort of news that's been going on recently with the zeros and the donuts has been really enjoyable, and really just, I feel really proud of my city and my community of just logging off or keep on going, I guess. So yeah. I'm really happy at the moment.
You said it sounds like you have a lot of friends and family around the world. So I guess you were used to keeping in contact with them over FaceTime or via phone calls. I suppose you just did that with all your other friends. Were you keeping in touch with your uni friends in the same way?
Yeah, absolutely. We would kind of have game nights where we would chat on Discord or WhatsApp or Messenger, and we would do little video calls and play a few fun games, like board games, but over a screen, I guess.
Yeah.
And I think that's the sort of main way we've been keeping in contact. But it has certainly kind of the disconnect of like not seeing each other has really kind of bare weight on a lot of my relationships that I've had, unfortunately. You know, I think certainly when I speak with a lot of my friends, sometimes it's just been feeling like it's a depressing conversation. But I think what we all felt, the need for just that companionship, really shine through. So even if we were talking about, oh yeah, you know, the numbers are really bad today, but you know, hey, I'm really happy that you're safe. I'm really happy that you're happy and just, you know, not any danger. And I think that's been really important during these days, just that sort of sense of connection and intimacy.
Definitely. It sounds like you've been very creative connecting together and instigating things like those online board games and, you know, ways of still maintaining those relationships.
Absolutely.
Did it change any other aspects of your life?
Yeah, absolutely. I think like COVID has affected like almost all aspects of my life, but with exercise, you know, staying motivated was really difficult throughout all this. And I think again with what you're saying about being creative with like having to do different things, I think we were put in a place where we had to, you know, or else it was either that or be a depressive mess. And I'm not gonna lie, that was the case for a few weeks, but hey, my cat and I were very comfy in our bed, so that was okay. But in terms of actual exercising, I think it was good for me to remember that I can do whatever small or little, and it would be good enough. And I didn't have to like have goals like wake up every day, you know, go to class and then do a hour-long workout with this person online. Throughout that journey, I learned that I need to be conscious of what I can do, not only what I need to do. And that ended up with me, you know, putting on some headphones whenever I wake up and turning on my mindfulness sort of playlist and going on a really short walk just around my house as an outside. And as I mentioned, there were a few sort of online personalities that did like online classes where you can actually work out with them. And I found that to be quite enjoyable as well. And I did that sort of thing.
But yeah, I think that's one of the things that have come out, you know, more opportunity for people who may find it hard to go to gym every day or weekly to get out of the house and go to a gym. But now it's more freely offered online and that can be more accessible for some people, which is, amazing opportunities that's come out of COVID.
Yeah, and I even was taking part in like a cultural dance class on Saturdays where we literally just had a random playlist and we would dance like nobody cared. And honestly, like that was an extreme workout, to be honest, but yeah. Nobody intended it to be. We were just like, hey, we're sad. We really miss going out. Let's just dance together. And we would turn our Zoom on and like put on a playlist of like 2000s classics or, you know, pop hits, and then just dance to One Direction like nobody was looking.
Yeah, lovely. And what a great idea.
It's really amazing and fun.
And did you feel the need or did you reach out to any services for support during that time, or did you just rely on your own social networks?
You know, I feel like I should really reach out to like outside sort of support in this time. And one of them was Headspace. And, you know, I started sort of seeing a psychologist there in February. And then I engaged with Deakin Counseling Services as well. They run some few like free sessions there. And I was able to see somebody and talk with them about uni stuff, about just friends and relationships, goals. Just the city of Melbourne hosted a few events online that really helped me connect with like my community in a way that I didn't feel like I was able to. They ran a few like short crafting sort of courses, and there was an embroidery course, like a fake foliage course, and a writing course. Yeah, there were a lot of opportunities to be creative, but also just be with like a really cool bunch of people and spend some good evenings.
Would have met new people out of those groups and done some things you probably wouldn't have done if COVID hadn't been around.
Completely. I think like the best thing has been like seeing and meeting people that I would like not have the opportunity for, you know, being busy doing biomed sometimes could be so exhausting that, you know, the last thing on my list would be being a normal teenager, you know, socializing. And, you know, now with like dating apps being a thing and like just online communities being so much more vocal and like friendlier and accessible, it's been like just a great opportunity to like have a meaningful relationship with people.
So yeah. Are there any other ways you'd like to think the community has come together to help each other out to get through COVID?
I think with uni and stuff going on, I think the lecturers and our teachers and even some of the other students are just, I've noticed people being more kinder to each other and like are more willing to listen than ever before, really. And I think that's been such a good sort of thing to just notice about humanity in such grim times. Like, you know, I think that's something nice that I noticed.
Yeah, I think I've noticed that a lot too. So do you think you would continue to do some of the things in what we would consider the new COVID normal?
No, certainly. I think this is like, as you were saying, you know, it showed so much value in like online sort of interface and doing things virtually. And, you know, like over the week, I would check in with a lot of my friends and even ask them if they want to do a video call just so we could chat and catch up with each other, the little things we did do over the week. But I think I can certainly see myself doing that, those things, and doing the dance class again, and just enjoying myself and be willing to kind of use those platforms and like see those as realistic options. But I think this could be really cool.
Yeah, because you were saying uni made you sometimes feel like you weren't living life as much as you would have, as you have been now. And engaging virtually or online it's an easier, it makes it easier to do that sometimes when life gets busy.
Certainly, like the online sort of curriculum now, and like just being able to access lectures when I want to, and things being according to my schedule, has been so helpful. But now, like, I can see myself incorporating those little things into my life and do things like before, like work and then come home, do a bit of lecture studying, and then like email my lecturer and like know that they would interact with me immediately, almost, you know, things like that. Like things seem more accessible and more for me rather than me having to do things for the purpose of doing it, if that makes sense.
So restrictions have eased and we're now, you know, celebrating because we have had 14 days straight of double donuts. Yay. But what message would you give to someone you know or someone you see that is unwell or showing COVID-like symptoms?
I think they really have to remember that this whole year has been a massive effort by not only the frontline workers, the healthcare workers, but also every single citizen of Victoria. And I think we have to take responsibility, each and every one of us, to keep that effort going and to do the little bit that we can do, you know, taking a bit of sick leave for 1 or 2 days and letting our managers or supervisors know, hey, I'm not feeling really well. I'll just get my COVID test done. And, you know, just be a bit more mindful of what things we can do. And with food services and like delivery things going on, it's been more easier than ever before, and it's more acceptable to take those sick leaves. And I think we need to take that authority and responsibility to keep ourselves and our community safe, and wear masks.
Yes, wear a mask for a little while longer, I think.
Exactly.
And finally, do you have a message for your community or your friends?
I think this year has been sometimes quite lonely and quite sort of disconnected. And, you know, I think a lot of people might relate to feeling really hopeless and kind of uncertain about these times. But, you know, having being in like the 11th month of the year, which is in November, crazy, you know, we have to realize we got through this because we have people who care about us, you know. We have people in our life who want us to be healthy, who care for us, who wish well for us. I hope everybody can stay well and stay safe. And I hope you and your family can stay well.
Thank you, Akand. So, such a lovely message. And I want to thank you again for sharing your experiences and your stories.
Oh, thank you. And thank you for giving me this platform.
It's a pleasure.